Hi, I'm Steve. You can call me Steve. The irises of my eyes are blue, although depending on the light, they might look gray. One person even told me they appear green, but I've never seen that. They've got a series of radial stripes and inner and outer bands of narrower stripes. They actually look pretty cool, and it's totally not narcissistic to stare into the mirror at your own eyes. Looking pretty is secondary to the iris's function of controlling the amount of light entering your pupils. But those two things are about all the iris is good for. It's not a diagnostic tool to determine the state of your health. The iris is a structure surrounding your pupil. In fact, the pupil is just the hole in the center of the iris that emits light into your eyes. The iris is mostly muscles that contract in a circular motion to control the amount of light that gets in. It's usually heavily pigmented to stop light leaking through the iris itself, rather than the pupil. That's why most people have brown eyes, especially people whose ancestors came from regions with strong sunlight. If you have light-colored eyes, like me, you actually have very little pigment in your irises, and you might be less tolerant to bright light than dark-eyed people. I know I sometimes find myself half-blinded if I walk outside on a bright day. Those stripes I described earlier are contraction ridges. They're the result of the material of the iris folding up on itself as it opens and closes. The pattern of the ridges is completely random. It has no genetic component, and we know this because identical twins will have non-identical eyes. Incidentally, my eyes are blue for the same reason the sky is blue. I don't have any blue pigment. Instead, blue light is scattered off the surface of my iris the same way it scatters off particles in the atmosphere. Explaining why the sky is blue is the first video I ever did, and no, I'm not going to link to it. What your iris can't do is tell you anything about your medical condition. That's a pseudoscience called iridology that claims that the various shapes and squiggles in your eyes reflect changes in your body, because apparently every part of your body is connected to your iris. This is the same concept as reflexology, and it's as completely wrong here as it was there. Not only is there no network of connections leading from every part of your body to your eyeballs, but the structures in your irises are long-lived and unchanging features, so much so they can be used for identification purposes. This would not be true if getting the flu caused visible changes. This is just a random, permanent pattern caused by folding tissue. Iridologists seem to have taken the metaphor of eyes being windows on the soul and failed to realize it's a metaphor. This particular brand of pseudoscience has a much older pedigree than some of the others I've talked about. It goes all the way back to 1665, but that seniority doesn't make it any more valid. It lingered in semi-obscurity until it was introduced to the States in the 1950s by a chiropractor. I will talk more about chiropractors in a future video. Even today, it's pretty obscure, although modern science has investigated and found it wanting. In 1979, three iridologists were given 143 pictures of eyes and told to identify which patients had kidney disease. They failed miserably, with a success rate equivalent to just random guessing. Just to reiterate, no, the squiggles in your eyes will not tell you anything about the state of your body. The lines and striations are due to the underlying muscle and other structures that open and close your pupil. It would be like trying to diagnose mechanical fault in an elevator by looking at the scratches on the doors. Don't let these charlatans fool you. If you think you have an illness, consult a real medical professional. I know that getting access to doctors or treatments can be difficult due to wait times or costs, especially in the States. And I also know that sometimes a doctor will completely ignore everything you say, especially if you're a woman, and diagnosed based on his or her, usually his, biases. Even though the quacks have better bedside manner and may genuinely care, they don't have the answers. They're not doctors, and they should not be allowed anywhere near patients. Don't trust them, don't promote them, and absolutely do not give them money. Thanks for watching. I've been Steve.